Welcome dear student, today we will see how to determine first order reaction rate constant. Aim to determine first order reaction rate constant. Requirements: chemicals, methyl acetate, 0.5 normal HCl, 0.1 normal sodium hydroxide, phenolphthalein indicator, and ice. Then apparatus: beakers, reagent bottles, conical flask, pipette, thermometer. First of all, we'll see what exactly the chemical kinetics. So chemical kinetic is also known as reaction kinetics. It is a branch of physical chemistry that is concerned with understanding the rates of chemical reactions. Chemical kinetic is a department of chemical science dealing with study of rate of reaction and the factors which affect the reaction rate. Means in any chemical reaction, what is exactly the rate of reaction and which factors exactly affect that rate of reaction is studied into the chemical kinetics. Then reaction rates. Rate of chemical reaction is nothing but change in concentration of reactant or product with time. The concentration of reactant is given into the mole per liter and it is changed with respect to time in second, minutes and hours. So rate of reaction is equal to change in concentration of reaction with respect to change in time. Then reaction rate is defined as change in a concentration of any reactant or product per unit time. So rate of reaction, when A is converted into the B, then in that case what happened? Rate of disappearance of A and rate of appearance of B will be there. So rate of reaction will be like this: decrease in a concentration of A with respect to time and increase in a concentration of B with respect to time, where this square bracket represents the concentration in moles per liter, whereas D represents infinitesimally small change in a concentration. Then negative sign shows that the reactant A decreases, whereas positive sign indicates increase in a concentration of product B. Reaction rate has the units of concentration divided by time. The unit for the reaction rate may be mole per liter into second, or mole liter inverse second inverse, or mole per liter into minute, or mole liter inverse minute inverse. You can write anyway. Then third thing, that is mole per liter into R, mole liter inverse and R inverse. Then we'll see molecularity of reaction. Molecularity of reaction is defined as number of molecules or atoms or ions that take part in the reaction. For example, one molecule of reactant is converted into the product, then molecularity will be 1. Say for example, N2O5 get converted into the N2O4, 1 half O2. So in this case, molecularity of reaction is 1. Then rate laws. At a fixed temperature of given reaction depends on a concentration of reactant, and the rate of reaction is directly proportional to the reactant concentration of each concentration being raised to some power. And for a substance A undergoing a reaction, then rate will be directly proportional to the concentration of A. We can write it as rate is equal to K, is nothing but constant, into concentration of A having a rest or power N. Then 2A plus B will give this product. And then in that case, the concentration of these two reactant affects the rate of reaction. Okay. Then the reaction rate with respect to A or B is determined by varying the concentration of one reactant and keeping other concentration of reactant constant. Means here what you have to do, you have to increase the concentration of any one reactant. And you have to study what exactly the effect is there on a product of that reaction when you are varying concentration of your one reactant. Okay, whereas you have to keep concentration of your second reactant constant. Then rate will be depend on concentration of A as well as concentration of B. K is nothing but constant. Then next parameter, that is order of reaction. It is defined as number of atoms or molecules or ions whose concentration determines the rate. Order may be zero or integer or fraction. It is also expressed as a sum of power of concentration of reactant. So here say A and B, these are the two reactants. According to the law of mass action, we can write it rate of reaction as a constant is equal to concentration of reactant divided by concentration of product. So here concentration is having some power, that is small a and small b. So the addition of this power will be the order of reaction. So A plus B is an order of reaction for this particular thing. Then we'll see different order of reaction. That is first zero order reaction. If rate of reaction is not depend on the concentration of any of its reactant, then the reaction is said to be zero order reaction. Rate of such a reaction depend on external factor like temperature, then light or any other factor than the concentration of reactant. Example of zero order reaction are alcohol absorption in the body and oxidation of vitamin A. Then apparent zero order reaction. It is a reaction which may be first order reaction but behave like a zero order reaction. For example, loss in a color of multi-sulfur product and disperse cysteine like pharmaceutical suspension. Okay, this reaction is apparent zero order reaction, but it behaves like a, so this is the first order reaction and behaves like a zero order reaction. As concentration of drug in the surrounding medium decreases, more drug is released from the suspended particles. and hence the concentration is maintained constant at any time t. But when all the suspended particles are converted into drug in a solution, the system changes into first order reaction. Then third order of reaction, that is first order reaction. A reaction is said to be first order when rate of reaction is dependent on of concentration of the reactants taking part in the reaction. It is proportional to first power of reactant. For example, decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, then hydrolysis of ethyl acetate in aqueous solution, then inversion of hydrolysis of sugarcane, diffusion of bridge cross biological membrane, and growth of microorganisms. Pseudo first order reaction. It is originally a second order, but it behaves like a first order. That's why it is called as the pseudo first order reaction. If one of the reactant is concentration is considered as a negligible, it is called a pseudo first order reaction. For example, hydrolysis of methyl acetate by an acid and a base hydrolysis of sucrose. Then second order reaction, when rate of reaction depends on concentration of two reactant, then it is called as second order reaction. In this reaction, rate of reaction is directly proportional to the product of concentration of two reactants. For example, alkaline hydrolysis of methyl acetate and hydrolysis of chlorobutanol. Higher order reaction, rate of reaction depends on concentration of more than two reactants, then it is called as the higher order reaction. For example, reduction of ferric chloride by stannous chloride and reaction of nitric oxide with oxygen. So these are the example of higher order reaction. Then half-life of reaction is defined as a time required for a concentration of reactant to reduce to half of its initial concentration. When say for example, initially 10 molecules of your reactants are there, then how much time is required to reduce its concentration up to 5? Okay, that time period is known as the half-life of the reaction. Then shelf life is defined as time required for the concentration of reactant to reduce up to the 90% of its initial concentration, that is a 10% decomposition. It is a technical term used for the expiry date of your pharmaceutical product. Then environmental storage condition like temperature, light, air, humidity and different types of packagings are affecting this shelf life. Okay, these are the external things which are affecting the shelf life of your product. Now we'll see first order reaction. Okay, in first order reaction, ingredient is responsible, or reactant is responsible for rate of reaction. That's why it is called as the first order reaction. Okay, initially, before a conversion of A into product, T will be zero. Concentration of A is given into the mole liter inverse. Then after time T, means when your reaction starts after time t, say for example 5 minutes, 10 minutes, the x mole of A have changed, or concentration of A is A minus x. Means initially the concentration of A will be small a, and after time t, some A is converted into your product. That's why ultimately concentration of your A will be decreased, and this will be A minus x. Okay, then first order reaction rate, that is dx upon dt, is directly proportional to the concentration of your reactant, that is A. Then we can rewrite it as dx upon dt, means change in a concentration of A with respect to time will be equal to k into A minus x. We can rewrite it as dx upon A minus x is equal to k into dt. So this is our equation 1. When we integrate this equation by rearranging, our equation will become integration of dx upon A minus x will be negative sign, integration A minus x is equal to kt plus I. So I is nothing but integration constant, and k is evaluated by putting t is equal to 0 and x is equal to 0. Okay, when we put this value t is equal to 0 and x is equal to 0, then our equation will become I is equal to integration of A, that is initial concentration of your A reactant. Okay, now we are going to put this value of I into equation 2. Then our equation will become integration of A upon A minus x is equal to kt. We can rewrite it as k is equal to 1 upon t, integration of A upon A minus x. So this is our equation 3. Okay, when you took the log of this equation, or we changing into the common logarithm, then our equation 3 will become 2.303 divided by t log of A upon A minus x. Okay, now we'll see what will be the unit of this first order reaction rate constant. So time is measured into the t is measured in as a time, then A will be the concentration, A minus x will be the concentration. So unit for the first order reaction rate constant will be time inverse. This concentration get cancelled, so it will become k is equal to 1 upon t. So we can write it as k is equal to time inverse. So this is the unit for first order reaction. Now we'll see actual theory behind this experiment. Methyl acetate undergo hydrolysis in the presence of hydrochloric acid. Then it gives acetic acid and methyl alcohol. Okay, this is the H plus ion received from the HCl, and when you treat it with the methyl acetate, then we'll get methanol and acetic acid. In the presence of acid, the reaction should be a second order, since two molecules are reacting, but it is found to be a first order. So how it is found to be first order? That rate of change of this reactant is directly proportional to the concentration of methyl acetate and what? Then water is present in excess amount, and its active mass virtually remain constant during the course of reaction. That's why we are considering here rate of reaction is only depend upon the concentration of methyl acetate. Its active mass gets included in a constant and above equation will be reduced to dx upon dt is equal to k into concentration of methyl acetate. Thus, the rate of reaction is determined by one concentration term only, that is CH3COOCH3. That's why it is first order reaction rate. Hence, reaction is first order. Such a reaction is also referred to as pseudo first order reaction. The progress of reaction is followed by removing definite volume of reaction mixture at a definite time interval and cooling it in ice and titrating an acetic acid formed against the alkali, which has already been standardized. Means you have to use already standardized alkali to determine how much acetic acid is formed during the completion of reaction. The amount of alkali used is equivalent to total amount of hydrochloric acid present originally and amount of acetic acid formed in the reaction. Then amount of acetic acid formed at a definite interval of time can be obtained. The amount of acetic acid formed at the end of reaction is equivalent to initial concentration of your ester. Suppose volume of sodium hydroxide solution required for the neutralization of 5 ml of reaction mixture are at the commencement of reaction is V0. After time t, it will be Vt. And at the end of reaction, it will be V infinity. When you start this reaction, means when your methyl acetate react with the water, then when you withdraw a first sample without any reaction, then you will require some alkali for the titrating this withdrawal sample, then that period reading will be your V0 value. Okay, when you withdraw a sample after time t, then that reading will be your Vt value. And when there is a completion of reaction and you are withdrawing a sample and titrating it against the alkali, that quantity of alkali will be your V infinity. Okay, so simply before starting of reaction, when your reaction in between, or you can say after time t and at the end of the reaction. So these are the three values of your alkali. Then x is proportional to the amount of acetic acid formed is directly proportional to the Vt minus V0. Means how much acetic acid is formed, that will be determined by the consumption of the alkali, and that consumption you can calculate by using Vt minus V0. Means before starting of reaction, how much alkali is required, and after time t, how much alkali is required. So this difference will give you how much acetic acid is formed, and that acetic acid is neutralized by the alkali. A is proportional to the V infinity minus V0, means initial concentration is directly proportional to the how much alkali is required. Then A minus X means concentration of your reactant after time t, that is A minus X is proportional to V infinity minus Vt. Okay, how it is V infinity minus Vt? First of all, it is depend upon the V infinity minus V0. Then Vt minus V0. When you simplify this equation, you will get V infinity minus V0 minus Vt plus V0. So your plus and minus V0 get cancelled and you will get V infinity minus Vt value. The first order rate expression is given by log of A minus X is equal to minus kt divided by 2.303 plus log A. Hence, the rate procedure: take 100 ml of 0.5 normal HCl in a reagent bottle in a constant temperature water bath and note the temperature. Then add 5 ml of methyl acetate solution to the above mentioned reagent bottle and note the time. Shake this reaction mixture and immediately withdraw 5 ml from it and transfer it to a conical flask containing crushed ice or cold water. Then titrate this mixture against 0.1 normal NaOH solution using phenolphthalein as an indicator, and this value corresponds to V0 value, means when you immediately withdraw 5 ml sample and it titrate against the 0.1 normal NaOH, that burette reading will be your V0 value. Then same step that is followed into the 3 and 4. We have to proceed for the time interval 5 minute, 10 minute, 15 minute, 20 minute, 25 minute, 30, 40 and 50 minutes. Means same thing we have to do, just there is a difference of time into the reaction between these two chemical, that is HCl and your methyl acetate. Means what happened after 5 minutes, what happened after 10 minutes. So that we have to determine by using requirement of ml of NaOH. Then you can determine how much acid is produced after 5 minutes, after 10 minutes. That is to be determined by using amount of alkali required to neutralize that acid. Okay. Then after 50 minutes, what you have to do? You have to reflux it on a boiling water bath for 1 hour, and after refluxation cool this reaction mixture and withdraw 5 ml reaction mixture and titrate it against the 0.5 normal NaOH using phenolphthalein indicator. Then this last reading will be V infinity value, means when you immediately withdraw a sample and titrate it, this will be your V0 value, and at the end when you reflux it and titrate it against the 0.5 normal sodium hydroxide, then this will be the V infinity value. Now we'll see actual demonstration of practical.
Now we'll see how to determine first order reaction rate constant by using methyl acetate. So, we'll take a quick revision of procedure. First of all, you have to take 100 ml of 0.5 normal HCl into the reagent bottle. Then you have to maintain a constant temperature of that bottle. Then add 5 ml of methyl acetate. Then shake this reaction mixture very well. Then you have to withdraw 5 ml of this reaction mixture into the ice or cold water. And then titrate it against the 0.5 normal. So this is the procedure where you withdraw first sample, very first when you add this methyl acetate into the HCl, this will be your V0 value. Okay, then when after time of 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, you will withdraw the sample and titrate against the 0.5 normal NaOH, this will be your Vt rate. Means after 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes up to 50 minutes, you have to withdraw a sample, and that reading will be your VT reading. Then what you have to do, remaining mixture you have to reflux, and that reflux solution, that means after 1 hour of reflexation, you have to withdraw the sample and titrate it against the 0.1 normal NaOH. This will be your V infinity reading.
So this is a reagent bottle. Very first step, that 100 ml of 0.5 normal HCl, I am going to take into this reagent. And I am putting it into the water bath, which is having a constant temperature, that is 40 degree centigrade. So I have set the thermometer in such a way that temperature of this mixture is constantly measured by using this thermometer. So here I am putting 40 degree centigrade temperature of this water bath and keeping this bottle into the water bath. I am going to add this 5 ml methyl acetate into this HCl. So this system is 40 degree centigrade. Now I am going to add methyl acetate into this HCl. Now this is methyl acetate. Now I'm adding this 5 ml methyl acetate and HCl. Now it starts to hydrolyze. Check it properly and immediately you have to withdraw 5 ml of this reaction mixture. And transfer into the conical flask. And in this conical flask, I am going to add this cold water. Check it well and titrate it against 0.1 normal NaOH. Then this will be my V0 reading. Now I am going to titrate it, add this phenolphthalein indicator 2 drops and then titrate it against. You have to titrate in such a way that you will get a constant pink color of this solution. Now it is converted into the pink color and my burette reading is 70 ml. Now we have finished 5 minutes. Now I am withdrawing a second sample from this reaction mixture. Here I have taken chilled water into this conical. and then I am going to titrate it against the 0.1 normal NaOH by using phenolphthalein indicator. Endpoint will be same, light pink color of solution will be there. Now it starts to convert into the pink color. So drop wise addition you have to maintain. Now permanent pink color is appeared to the solution and my burette reading is 75 ml. Previously I have added 50 ml and this 25 ml, so burette reading is 75 ml. So in this way we have taken 0 minute reading and 5 minute reading. So what you have to do, you have to continue this titration for the 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minute, 25 minute, 30 minute, 35, 45 and 50 minute. So likewise you have to withdraw a 5 ml sample for the time interval and titrate it against the 0.1 normal NaOH and note down the burette reading. Now I have noted a reading for the 50 minutes and this remaining solution I am putting for the reflux. I have said the reflux assembly and I am going to put this remaining solution for the reflexation. Now we have to put it for the reflux for 1 hour and then proceed for the next part. Now we have completed 1 hour. Now I am going to remove this round bottom flask which is having a reaction mixture in it. Then transfer this 5 ml reaction mixture into a conical flask which is having a chilled water in it. Then add phenolphthalein indicator and titrate it against the 0.1 normal NaOH. Now our reaction mixture is converted into the light pink color and the red reading is 130 ml. So this is our V infinity value. Now we'll proceed for the calculation part.
Now we'll go through the observations. So temperature I have maintained of water bath, that was 40 degrees centigrade. Then V0 value observed 70 ml. Then V infinity value 113 ml. Then initial concentration of ester we can calculate by using V infinity minus V0 value, and it is 43 ml of NaOH is required for the ester. This is observation table. So this is the time span, means I have withdraw a sample at a 0 minute, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 40 and 50. So these are the Vt values and this is my V0 value. Then these are the readings for this time interval. Then here I have calculated X value. Now this X value is calculated by using Vt minus V0. As we all know, V0 is 70. That's why 70 minus 70 it is 0. Then 73 minus 73. So likewise, we have to calculate this column. Then calculate A value. Now A value will be V infinity minus 43. That is constant. That is 43 ml. Then you require to calculate this A minus X value. Now A value is constant and X value is variable for the different time span. So that you have to calculate A minus X. Then you have to take a log of this value. Then you have to put this value in this equation and calculate the reaction rate constant, that is K value. Okay, formula for the reaction rate constant, 2.303 divided by T into log of A upon A minus X. Now we have a value with us, that is 43, and A minus X is different for the different time span. So first K value 2.303 at the zero time interval, log A upon A minus X, so it becomes 0. Then for the 5 minute, 2.303 divided by 5 into log of A, that is 43. A minus X for the 5 minute was 40 and answer is 0.0144 minute inverse. Then accordingly you have to calculate for the next minute. So this is for the 10 minute and it is 0.0123. Then for 15 minute it is observed 0.0137 minute inverse. Then for the 20 minute it is 0.01312 minute inverse. Then for the 25 minute 0.0186 minute inverse. For 30 minute it is 0.0208 minute inverse, and for 40 minute it is 0.01792 minute inverse. Then for the 50 minute 0.0336 minute inverse. Now what you have to do, we have to take an average of all these 9 values. So these are my all 9 values and I am going to take its average. Now my calculated average value is 0.01604 minute inverse. So this is the reaction rate constant we have calculated theoretically. Now we'll move towards the graph. Now we'll see how to calculate by using graph. So what we have to do, you have to calculate first graph log of a minus x versus time. And then you have to take its slope by using equation y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Then k value will be minus slope into 2.303. Now we'll see how to calculate it. Now here I have plotted a graph log of a minus x versus time. Then I have draw a line, then selected 2 points, that is 1 and 2, and taken its slope, that is y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. Then this value, calculated value of slope is minus 0.006. Okay, so when you put it into the equation, slope is equal to minus k upon 2.303, then my graphical k value is 0.0138 minute inverse. So in this way we have calculated reaction rate constant theoretically as well as graphically. Then result, reaction rate constant for acid catalyzed hydrolysis of methyl acetate was found to be 0.016404 minute inverse, and this is a graphical value for the reaction rate constant, 0.0138 minute inverse. Now we'll move toward the questions asked for the synopsis as well as viva for this particular practical. So first question is, define reaction rate constant. As we have seen, rate of reaction is equal to change in a concentration of reactant or product with time. Then define order of reaction. So order of reaction is defined as a number of atoms or molecules or ions whose concentration determines rate. Order may be zero or integer or fraction, and it is also expressed as a sum of power of concentration of reactant. So sum of power will be your A plus B. Okay, this is the power, small a is the power of your A reactant, small b is the power of your B reactant. Okay, and as per the definition, it is sum of power of concentration of reactant. So we have a two reactant A and B with us, and its powers addition is A plus B. So this will be your order of reaction. Then what is first order reaction? So it is said to be first order when reaction is dependent on a concentration of one reactant taking part in the reaction, and it is proportional to first power of reactant. See, for example, decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, then hydrolysis of ethyl acetate in aqueous solution, then inversion of hydrolysis of sugarcane, diffusion of bridge cross biological membrane, and growth of microorganisms. So these are the few examples of first order reaction. What is half life? Now half life is defined as a time required for the concentration of reactant to reduce half of its decimal, so for its initial concentration, means if it is initially 10 and when it is reduced up to 5, then time span required to convert that initial concentration from 10 to 5, this will be the half-life of that particular substance. Give equation for half-life of first order. So this is the equation for half life. T half is equal to 0.693 divided by reaction rate constant. This is all about determination of rate of reaction, which is first order. Thank you.